need to cook that. Where did the bucket go? Had a bucket. Yeah, screw it. Come on. Yes. Help? Okay, that's just gonna ignore that. So I'm guessing you couldn't connect.
Still having difficulty with biomes.
Yeah, that's just weird. Well, I guess I'll have two different flavors of Minecraft this week. Yeah, I'm currently working on setting up another portal network between the different villages I found.
There we go. Hello and welcome to the episode of Christian's podcast. Good friends, two of the business is going to be Steam until the recent. It'll be the first 2 months show since the announcement regarding the situation with the. Main artists and things like that. Thankfully, I've turned myself not to be too surprised.
Yes. Yeah. Expect more game streams.
Summary of that message here. Anyway, this week on the news desk, the Godzilla vs. Kong crossover has been postponed for 2021. Other crisis going on at the moment will somehow leak into the entertainment industry. Anyways.
Yeah.
We've already mentioned Justice League getting a director's cut. Apparently a Suicide Squad director's cut is also in the talks. So that will be something.
I think that was the right one.
Doug Liman to direct Tom Cruise in a movie that's filmed in space. Hard to tell exactly when filming will commence, but that's interesting to note.
Yeah.
It's taken 3 or 4 years, but Labyrinth is going to get a sequel directed by Scott Derrickson. The question is, what they're thinking of in terms of the sequel, Indy 5, James Mangold to direct, and Spielberg is in the producer's chair. Naturally, there's some back and forth, given what's been done to Star Wars, at least in terms of the movies, but I'm basically like, some could work. It's fortunate there are some people in that similar category just mainly wishing there aren't aliens this time around. This one's a bit old and we'll tie into a personal note. I will talk later, but the live-action Aladdin is going to get a sequel.
Wait, what?
Not going to be too surprised. They end up being live-action versions of the animated sequels.
Yeah.
Oh, this is a fun one. Paul Feig blames the heat of the 2016 election for the Ghostbusters backlash / controversy.
Wow. Just wow.
Not too surprised, to be honest. Especially given, and a little interesting. Given the heat that's been erupting across cities recently. But we won't go too deep into that.
another village.
Super Nintendo World coming soon to Universal Parks.
Yeah, that's pretty interesting.
Really need to check what really need to check a licensing agreement. Really need to check the licensing things at some licensing step at some point, but that'll be interesting. I know I said we wouldn't get too deep into the riots, but close to the beginning, Denzel Washington prevented death of a homeless from the same race.
Yeah.
Look at him.
Hello.
Sonic 2 is in development. Naturally, it's going to be a while before principal photography begins, but there's another one to add to my watch list.
I heard the first one was good, or at least not bad. So it's like, okay. I personally haven't seen it myself, but you know, I haven't heard horrible things about it, so that's a good sign.
I kind of anticipated this following the closing scenes revolving around the credits, particularly I don't know if you've seen this on the webs or whatnot, but Tales was teased.
Yeah, I know. Another village. Again.
Not sure if anyone's familiar with this, but there's an upgrade sequel TV series in the works at Blumhouse with Lee Whannell attached to direct. Warner is reportedly planning another Harley Quinn film featuring the featuring Margot Robbie.
Yeah, that's to be expected. And that it's that, that given that it's one of the few DC things to actually do well, is anything with her in it. Oh. Darn.
J.K. Simmons to play J.J. Jameson in future Spider-Man projects.
I mean, yeah, it's, of course. Really, it couldn't be anyone else.
Seriously, thought that my Spider-Man film knowledge. Anyway, we finally got some release dates regarding Pony material. Next month, the first bits of Pony Life will start to drop. So, possibly add that to our inventory.
Yeah.
IDW has finally released some official statements regarding comic delays. Expecting some July and August release dates.
Yep, so it'll still be a while, but at least now we know exactly when.
From a trusted source, of course.
Ice. All right, self touch for even packed ice.
Finally, the casualty report this week, and there's some interesting names in the industry. Well, related to the entertainment industry. Canadian rapper Houdini.
Never heard of him.
Bob Kulick, who, of course, was partially responsible for the... who was, of course, partially responsible for Sweet Victory. Sadie's not going to get a full version at the Super Bowl. And actually related to the subject matter we've been covering for the entirety of the month, Michael Angelos.
Yeah. Ooh. Who are you two then, polar bear? Like, you all saw that was self-defense. I think he's trying to throw a trident at me. Oh, that guy is throwing the trident. Ow.
It was a little interesting on Twitter, though. Aside from the riots that are going about, he was one of the hot things that was constantly flogging in my notifications.
Ah.
And with that, we move on to our subject of the day, which will close out our full month of celebration over the 75th anniversary of the railway series. Thomas and the Rail Engine.
Yeah, this was a bit of a shorter one than usual. Only clocking in about 23 minutes. buried treasure map.
Approximately at the same time as a what I believe is still a regular broadcast time, but
yeah,
what I believe is still a regular broadcast time, and of course the only difference is that regular broadcasts usually have two episodes and a couple learnings. Regular episodes and the occasional learning segment. And this was singular.
So the episode begins with Sir Topham Hatt getting a letter. Yeah, apparently the queen wants to give him a war. Slowing down. The queen wants to give him an award, and also the prince wants Thomas to be there. The other ninjas are wondering why Thomas. Well, his name is in the title of the series, so yeah, tough luck there.
I do like that they refer to some stuff of before, including when the Queen visited the island, as well as that one time Gordon went to London.
Yeah. I think I'm gonna go east. But yeah, so actually he got the letter a bit late, so yeah, he has to be there tomorrow, so yeah, Thomas has to get up bright and early. So the next day rolls around, and okay, Thomas is ready, Sir Topham Hatt is ready, they're good to go. So they head off. Have you been keeping track? Thomas has no idea where anything outside of Sodor is located. And sometimes things in Sodor aren't so whatever. Thomas isn't very good with locations.
Kind of strange the crew didn't intervene. Given some events before.
Yeah, you'd think by now, someone would have brought a map around with them. But it's fine. So Thomas is traveling along, and yeah, we get a special guest. It's that crane from last week. It was last week, right?
Yeah, Brother Sir from Journey Beyond Sodor makes an appearance in this. Thankfully, our time with him is brief. And also thankfully, he's not the staying type this time around.
But yeah, so they chat for a bit. Come on. Sorry, runaway Endermen. And zombies. I'll be right back after I deal with this guy. Really, no enderpearls? Anyway, so yeah, they chat for a bit, and He tells Thomas that, like, okay, go left at the next junction. Right, no left. Whatever. Yeah, you can start to see where this is going.
Oh, that joke.
Yeah, so, next junction. Righto. Right. Oh. He goes right. So, yeah, they're lost. And it's like, Thomas gets scratched up, loses some of the banners. Sir Topham Hatt constantly loses his hat. I want to get on this ice. Okay, but yeah. Also, Sir Topham Hatt's suit gets scratched up and torn, and yeah, he's not having a very good day. But okay, fine. So, they finally reach this one to this town. And, okay. Fine. Sir Topham gets off the... off and, goes to get freshened up a bit. And, yeah. Sir Thomas is waiting around, and all of a sudden this new engine shows up, and starts telling him to, give her the car that's attached. Like, no, this is my car. It turns out she was mistaken. Her cars were somewhere else. But yeah, turns out her name is Duchess. She'll be important later. Yeah, Thomas gets so old to, get a bit of a wash, and he starts heading over to the wash station, and it's bumped out of the way by Duchess, who gets cleaned up, and they chat for a while. Like, she has some very important work to do. Like, fine. So, Thomas' turn to get washed. Oops, all out of water. So, he heads back, and yeah, Sir Topham Hatt is there, like, oh no, we have to get to London in an hour. We have to go now. So it's like, okay, we'll go. Except, they kind of forgot the fire guy there. It's like the guy who shovels the coal in, and yeah, that's, oops.
Attempts to get a sense of direction, and also apparently the, Wasn't anything to help with the suit, apparently.
Yeah.
Also, the hat doesn't have much luck either.
Yeah, the hat got squished. The hat is pretty much done. It is dead. Rest in peace, hat. Rest in pieces, hat. But yeah, and as this is going on, he's constantly bumping into the Duchess and asking, and like, just talking, and so yeah, no fire guy. Well, we have to get there quick. So Sir Topham Hatt passes off his completely ruined jacket, and it's like, okay, my turn to help out. As he said, like, you don't do this kind of job that long without having to get your hands dirty.
Kind of work.
Yeah, another drowned.
Kind of helps that. I'm obviously a bit more familiar with some of the I'm obviously a bit more familiar with previous encounters of this kind of thing, but A, his family was always railway A, his family was always railway tied, so there had to have been an engineer or a fireman at some point.
Yeah.
And B, there was an actual episode where he took this mantle temporarily.
Ah. But yeah, so yeah, Thomas starts speeding up again, and yeah, turn looks sorry, brain going too quick. Yeah, Duchess is up ahead, and she stopped, and oh yeah, the thing she forgot to check, it was the boiler cap, was it, or
Safety
something
valve.
like that.
Safety valve.
Safety, yeah. But yeah, she's out of commission. But it's like, hey, I need to get this stuff to London. Hey, we're going to London. I'll push, you lead. Okay, go teamwork. Yeah, trying to find this buried treasure. But yeah, so they finally get to London, and Sir Topham gets off and like, okay, we're finally here. Oh hey, Duchess, she's a royal engine. And like, this is something I saw coming. Duchess, her important cargo was the Queen.
Granted, a lot of the things are there to kind of see a, kind of things are there to kind of see it coming. So, good call.
Yeah. I got trying to find buried treasure in a frozen ocean. Ugh. But yeah, so the queen gets off the tr gets out of the car. It's like, oh, hey, you're supposed to be at the palace. Yeah, having some difficulties with that, but yeah, so she says like, okay, to avoid further trouble, let's just do the ceremony here. Here's your award, and the prince gives Thomas a little a medal. It's like, and here's this and. And yeah, Thomas was a royally useful engine. And everyone's happy, and the treasure should be around here somewhere. But yeah, that was the movie. Not bad. Aha. Ooh. Okay. Here are your planks. Part of the sea. Diamonds.
I'd say it was a pretty good official 75th celebration special.
Yeah.
And who would have thought there would be a guest at the beginning? Well, before the special got started.
Yeah, I did notice that. Okay, I swear I saw a village over this way.
So yeah, the reactions I've heard about, the things I've heard about this have been completely justified. Including from a briefcase from before we got started. Who says at the moment he is a favorite of the current series that's going to be dropping over time this year.
Loki Village. But yeah, it's like, it was good. The twist was a bit predictable, but, you know. That's not bad, you know.
The clues were obvious, but overall, it certainly. Well, the clues were obvious, but overall, it definitely. Overall, they didn't ruin the fun.
Right. Is there not a waste down at this village? Ew. Okay. Ah, good doggos.
So back to that personal note that I mentioned earlier. The family members we've been housing have rented movies over the course of the week, starting shortly before last week's guest.
Yeah.
And I took the liberty of checking out at least four of the five. Since one is technically sequel to something I haven't seen yet.
Okay.
As I mentioned, one of them was the live action Aladdin.
Of course.
At this point, there are two arguments that I'm posing to. The occasional whiner. When is actually a really true quote from a game trailer that used to play? Do whatever it takes to survive. That seems to be what Disney's doing.
Yeah.
Second argument. I think it's fair to say some people will have problems with the originals.
Yeah. Okay, so that map just takes me to the one I already found. No. Don't want to toss the diamond pick.
Same
back there.
Same goes with the live action Lion King. And according to, I have to agree with a lot of comments when I was listening to some of the music for some time afterwards. At least they're good in the music department. Moving away from remakes. They also rented the latest version of Little Woman.
Oh.
I think my biggest compliment on that would be how it was framed, how it was shot. I think it was the look of the picture that certainly was a major highlight, in my opinion.
Okay.
Not to say everything else is bad, and as usual, Louisa May Alcott, and I'm sure a Louisa May Alcott book is usually a classic.
Yeah.
One of the fastest home media releases in recent years. Onward.
Yeah, that was a thing. Shit.
Honestly, I can't remember the last time I watched something in the something in terms of brotherly bonding, but yeah, I thought that part was good. Also, the setting is what really defines the movie. Fantasy and reality mixed into one. And the one I didn't watch, at least in full, because again, it's a sequel to something I need to watch. It was the second Maleficent movie. And I'm kind of under distinction of treating it similarly to the new Ghostbusters, where it's kind of a parallel universe of sorts.
Right.
As a means to try and sway off the eventual comments regarding comparisons to the original Maleficent.
Of course.
On that note, it definitely looked a little fascinating.
Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna put that there. I'm sure I'll need the sand later for my village anyway. Yeah, thank God for the haste totems. God, I wish I could make that X transparent. I can't see where I'm trying to dig. Or where I have to dig. That'll be in one of these spots. Maybe. Does that. And back home. Let's see now. Anything? anything newsy? A Harry Potter RPG? What? Oh, that's different. Well, time to find some cows. I got sheep, pigs, chickens, but not cow. Okay, avoid the creeper. I wonder if the village has any cows. Okay, so that's a yes for that. Yeah, that explains it. The two nitwits are stuck in a well.
Nothing new to me. I've had the occasional encounter in single player.
Now that it's much exploring in this direction. But check this out. Oh, for a second there, I thought I saw I thought it was mushroom, but it was just a cow taking damage. Yoink. I'm not gonna say no to free mossy cobble. Oh, that does it actually have a use? Really? Ooh. Another regeneration? I have so many of those.
You know, it's kind of funny. You know, it's kind of funny. For some reason now I'm thinking that mod should have been done by a Doctor Who fan. Then the effects could have been present. or to the best of Minecraft's ability.
Right. I'm trying to find a good spot to start up my village. Like, I want a nice, relatively flat area. Ooh, waystone. Hey, murder. God. Oh, that's certainly a name.
guess I guess I can go about my memories of Vangelis. Aside from the New Friends for Thomas DVD, I think most of my exposure to him has been when episodes were read, when episodes were not under copyright blockage threats from YouTube. I'm pretty sure they're still. It's safe to say they're still available for. Safe to say they're still available for watching, but. Yeah, those were the more major exposure, at least for me. At least for me, and I've ended up having to use his audio on several audio on a few occasions when I used to do model-based reenactments. But yeah, like a lot of US people, I'm more familiar with Carlin, Baldwin, Brandon.
Right.
Although we did end up ordering a lot of U.S. Ringo tracks. Oddly enough, wasn't a fan of him for a while until I, heard of his Beatles background, so I started getting a bit more respect. He always sounded a little strange to me as a kid.
Okay, Red War. I am more white sheep. They have two whites. Okay. That away. That. Mixing up my mod recipes. There was another thing. was I trying to... No. Okay, what can I do with wheat? I should probably make one of those. Okay. Maple saplings. Okay, 1,000 blocks that way. But just in case. So there might actually be a mushroom biome. Good. Portal. Actually, if I find a flat spot here, this wouldn't be that bad of a place to. Ooh, village. Be that bad of a place to go, because if I remember correctly, hostile mobs don't spawn in mushroom biomes.
Interesting side effect on livestock.
Okay, so this village is broken, but it does have the waystone. What the? Huh. Exactly. Wait, what? Okay, I think the generation of this village kind of broke a bit, because there are four waystones. Yeah, that's not supposed to happen. Ooh, a smithing table. Eastern. Yeah, we should probably start to wrap things up a bit since it's getting kind of late.
So, out of all the content that we've watched, which one would you say is a favorite?
I want to say it was. Which one was it? The one where he got lost in that mine shaft.
Great discovery.
Yeah.
On a visual note, I can see where you're on a visual note, I can definitely see where you're coming from. In terms of writing, though, I still Call Adventure Begins my per Call Adventure Begins my favorite. Obisanzu was good, don't get me wrong. And I'd certainly put it on a high note if I ever get to that list.
Right. I'm sorry, sir, you have to. Oh, I'm sorry, sir, you have to dive for abilities. Okay, what did I get? Okay, I definitely need to check the config settings. Cause I just got another regeneration totem.
I'd also say the Rail Engine certainly is a better note than some other specials I could probably mention in terms of celebratory entries.
Right.
But I still think Adventure Begins embraces the source material, just a little bit more. Probably the most out of the celebratory material that I've seen over the course of my time in this time as a Thomas fan. So it's been kind of interesting. So it's been kind of interesting month in terms of anniversary celebrations. From the back and forth that the fandom has been at to my colleagues' reactions. A little unfortunate that the crisis regarding searching for the content for this episode as well as the whole pandemic in general has kind of relaxed my runnings a bit, but I have managed to slightly get back into the whole planning stages. I can safely say that most of next month will be back to Gravity Falls, with two exceptions.
Oh.
Apart from the first, of course, being Pony Life, the second probably not going to be. Not sure how big the number's going to be in terms of celebratory status, but it is still going to be related to a anniversary thing, regardless. Okay, so it'll be 42 by the time we get there.
Okay.
In the meantime, it's pretty. Oh, yeah. Don't expect him every time situation. Its obvious reactions are still on hold.
Yeah.
So until next week, stay safe, stay well, especially given
just generally everything.
how the situation has generally started to escalate. But hopefully, you can join us next week for a return of Gravity Falls. Take care.